Now coming to the plate for the Bulldogs, center fielder number 4, Taylor Waters.
One of the things that's obviously interesting and mostly male-dominant athlete class, she's one of 2 girls that's been in the class the whole year, and I think it's a little intimidating for a lot of the girls, so for her just to take the class is says a lot in itself, because you know she has been with a bunch of males, and it's always interesting to see how the girls respond, because some of them won't do anything in front of the males because they're scared to, what are they going to say? And she came in, you know, she's a smaller girl.
Yeah.
She's young, so she has had a lot of room to go as far as developing her strength.
Yes.
But because of that competitive demeanor, she's made huge strides
okay.
in that area. And I think she's got a little bit of room to go there, but she's definitely doing the things she needs to get that.
All right, folks, here we go for game number 2 today between your running board. Thank you.
Well, first of all, and every coach loves it, she has speed. Speed that can change the dynamics of the game. It's hard to defend against the speed. She's been on the left side for, I think this is her second year, making progress. Really good with the bunt. The slap is coming, but we're working on the hitting. So you can be three-dimensional because we know, and with our experience in the 18 gold level, you know, you have to be multi-dimensional. Right. And Taylor's doing a nice job hitting the ball. Okay. And also the slap. Excellent. So, and then in outfield, I think she played shortstop the majority of the time when she was younger.
She did.
But we put her in center field, and she just has defense. She's going to get to a ball in the gap, and I'm not sure what her time is. I mean, you know, it all depends how you take it. She's just fast. So, yeah. We, you know, she is certainly like 2.8, however you measure it.
Yeah.
But she also has game speed, and that's something I think that really benefits our team. I think she has some room to grow physically. Okay. And once she does that, you know, the ball's going to bounce off her bat a little bit more, and she's going to get faster. So,
good. How is she as a teammate? How is she with the other girls and as a lead, as a cheerleader on the team or anything like that?
Well, Taylor has a big spirit, and for a little girl, she has a loud voice. So we always like to hear that in the dugout, and she's a very good student in the classroom. And all of our kids are wonderful, and they support each other. And you know, one thing about Taylor is even when things aren't going her way, you know, she'll pick up the other players. It's easy to be, you know, positive when you're winning and things are going well.
Right.
But Taylor, you know, has played enough sports to understand that, you know, you just have to stay up all the time. So we look for her to be a leader on the team and help her teammates.
And is she coachable? That would be a good question to ask.
Yes, she's very coachable. You know, you just have to keep after it. You know, she's 15 years old, I think, you know, and so we can't say, you know, she's at that college level. But again, I think it's going to be a maturity level.
That's
and
true.
She certainly wants to play at the next level. So I think that's what's going to help her the most is to put in the time and understand that there are things that everybody needs to work on.
Yeah.
But she's very talented. She has speed because it comes back to that. She can play defense, you know, in the outfield. And so, I think it'd be an asset for most college programs.
Excellent.
I know.